Welcome, guys, to my Let's Play of D4, Dark Dreams Don't Die, where we left off. We had a very cool fight scene, and the plane indeed got electrified. Oh, I'll take that, thank you. And now we're just trying to see what happened since people disappeared. We should really move that, which I know we have to, so let's move that. Hope ya. Oh, look, there's a kitty. Let's say hi to the kitty. Let's just do a nice tap push. Okay. So yeah, as it says, we have to find all pieces of evidence in regards to what happened to the plane. So we'll start at the top. Especially since I see our detective.
Marshall, are you okay? What's with the attitude? I'm only asking because I was worried. You'd think nothing happened at all.
I don't need your jabber, boy.
Derek Buchanan. I'm not sure why, but he seems determined to ignore me.
Can't remember which one I picked. You know, I'm just gonna pick a random one. Let's go wife. Oh, there we go.
You've got quite a young wife. Is there a big age gap between you? You're giving courage to men all across our fair nation. If a stony-faced gorilla like you can marry such a young, beautiful creature, there's hope for all of us yet, isn't there? But that's a surprise. You're the last person I'd expect to be carrying a picture of your family.
Listen up. I don't know who you are. But if you want to keep sucking down air, never talk to me again. A man is far more than just his looks. My wife understood that.
Marshall Buchanan doesn't know who I am? There's something very odd going on here. But just what is it?
Alright, well, let's kind of go like this.
My turn, asshole!
Marshall. I'll be slapped with a match penalty if I push my luck any further. I'd better look for another way before I'm sent off for good.
Clearly doesn't want to talk to us. So let's see what we can find here. This is pretty amusing, I'm not gonna lie.
Go Boston, go!
Nothing says Boston quite like this. There must be a baseball fan on board.
Yeah, it's kind of amusing. I would say the baseball fan would be our lovely, the rabbit. I can't remember his full name right now, but he's the only one that pops to mind, especially because, you know, he decided to throw a baseball at us. Oh. Okay, there we go. I like the item on the left.
Where'd the courier go to?
But I like the burger as well, especially because we eat that for stamina. Now let's talk to our lovely avant-garde. He has changed clothing. Very military-esque.
Oh, my Sherry, I know. You must have been so scared. How is my Suki? Okay? There'll be champagne as soon as we arrive in DC. Ooh, I think some Chardonnay might be nice.
Didn't your mannequin just break?
Hey! Excuse me! Shizuki, not a mannequin! Therefore, she most certainly cannot ever just break. Do you intend to make an enemy of the entire fashion industry?
No. That mannequin got totally wrecked.
Tut tut! Say another word, mister, and I shall unleash my anger!
Okay, you win. Forget I even asked about your mannequin. My bad. No more about Suki.
That's right. She's not a mannequin. We can forget this ever happened. Of course, us being top fashion designers, we're never going to remember you anyway. I don't do autographs. I'm here on my private time.
When did you become a military maniac?
This is a fashion, you heathen. Retro and military, it's called. Both Suki and I are completely anti-war, of course.
Okay. But what I really wanted to know was, when did you change your clothes?
Progress cannot be stopped. When we changed is not what is important. Rather, the question should be, when can we change? Indeed, just look. The fashion we have on right now is already headed toward obscurity. It's imminent, like fluttering petals. At any moment, new inspiration is going to just explode into my brain. Like,
oh, I know this. We know this. Oh, corn. Oh, we should pick corn. But no, it's scarred.
Your mannequin, I mean, is Suki really okay?
You're so persistent. Look at her smooth, perfect body. She doesn't have a mark on her. Oh, you're so good. Oh, my Suki. Suki. You are just too lovely. If I were to lose you, I doubt I could go on living.
This does look like the real Suki. See just what's going on here.
So yeah, even costume-wise, things are a little weird. Oh, we have a blue. Oh, right. There we go. I was looking for that. This is part of an extra case. I was kind of worried, because like I said, I played ahead. I lost the data if the extra cases would show up again. And indeed they have. So let's pursue or continue this one.
You've got red powder on your clothes. What is it?
Oh, excuse me. Now then, where exactly is this red powder on my clothing? I don't see anything at all.
An elite fashion designer and a mysterious powder? My instincts as a former narcotics detective tell me something's up. I'll question it and find out more.
So yes, we're such a... question him about it. I believe it's the fashion world. Yes.
Brilliant lights cast deep shadows.
What's that supposed to mean?
Musicians, artists, designers, top clientele for drug pushes.
I don't deny it.
And you're one of them too?
I don't need that stuff. I've got Suki. There's nothing that can possibly stimulate me more than her. Comparing her to the effects of mere chemicals, synthetic drugs, you may as well just slap her in the face.
And then, oh, it's the same options. Okay, well, let's go through them all.
Yours is a world of trends, isn't it? There are trends in drugs, too. You're sensitive to trends, right? You know what I'm talking about. Real blood. The ultimate drug. Considered the final and best of the blood series. As the name might suggest, it's a bright red powder. Just like the suspicious powder I saw on your clothing.
You seem quite desperate to paint me as a junkie. But you're just overthinking things. The substance you question is nothing like that silly real blood. It's far more wonderful, revolutionary, like a completely new age. For now, well, just call it D.
So yeah, let's keep harassing him.
Tell me more about this new age.
No comment.
If it's all legit, surely you can tell me about it.
It isn't time to reveal anything yet. You'll hear about it soon enough, along with the rest of the world.
So you're planning on spreading a new age called D across the entire world simultaneously?
No comment.
This guy could be a lot more dangerous than he looks. I'll try taunting him a little. I've worked it out. The D of this new age is the D from Duncan. In other words, you want to make your own name the symbol of this new age. The whole world will be under the spell of the red powder that bears your name. But that isn't art. It's just attention seeking. The desire for conquest. Just another wannabe dictator. Is that what Suki wants?
Say whatever you like. It's not like you can stop me.
This guy is tougher than I thought. He knows I don't have anything on him, okay? I'll slap him with some proof. Something he can't run away from. All this talk of a new age called D, though. I just hope my bad feeling about all this is way off the mark.
So yes, which it already started as in vision mode. Essentially, we need to find the powder. The only way you can see it is in vision mode, which you can turn on and off, but if you notice on the ground, there's no red marks. As soon as I turn vision on, though, you can see the powder. I know where the powder is. Essentially, vision is kind of that cheat mode. But I don't really like using it, because I enjoy going through things a little blind. Anyway, I need to heal. I think there's some bandages in the bathroom, if I remember correct. We're just going to investigate these lovely cabinets. Sorry, brain fart. And see if I can find bandage. I did find food, which is fantastic. So we'll grab that.
Would never hide in here.
No, but burgers will. Apparently, all these burgers will you know, hide nicely in the cabinet or compartments of the airplane.
There's nothing here.
Oh, there's water. Be quiet. Water restores vision, so we'll definitely take that. And we'll take that. But I still need first aid. We'll talk to her in a second. We'll get this open. We'll move this, I should really say. Because I want to finish with Duncan first. And check in here.
It's a domestic flight. No large bags.
Might just grab that too, even though I've already got the clothing. Now, there's the chips. Where was that? Oh, yeah, I saw the metal, which I've already gotten. Well, we'll find what I'm looking for in a bit. I know it says to check that.
The cherry blossoms and snow are switched. The cherry blossoms should be on the back.
So yeah, there's a hint there. But...
It's like I'm not even here.
Okay, he's not gonna move for me. I need to talk. Oh. Okay, we need to push him. Oh, this is gonna be a joy. It's gonna be a pure joy. Let's do this. Oh, I can't profusely tap on him. Oh. Sad panda.
Control will be an issue if I can't find it. Sir, can I help you with anything?
Where's Olivia?
Excuse me, sir. Exactly which Miss Olivia are you searching for?
Olivia Jones. She's a member of the crew, just like you are.
I'm very sorry, sir, but she isn't aboard this flight.
Come on. Did that lightning strike you too? She was right here a moment ago. In any case, you need to contact Logan Airport immediately. Tell them we have an emergency up here. Also, get the BPD to send some cops to the airport. Detective Forrest Kazin in particular. Give him my name and you'll have no problems.
Well, excuse me, sir. Are you hoping to use this confusion for something nefarious? If so, I'll have to stop you.
Next time, I'll break more than your watch.
My most humble apologies, Mr. David Young. This incident has us all a little riled up, I'm sure.
Huh?
I'll make the call about the suspicious person immediately. To our destination, Ronald Reagan International Airport. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to work.
Okay, so we did get a second piece, but I need to go to the washroom. Because if I remember correct, there are bandages in them, and also something important involving Duncan. So there's the bandages. So he's a little bit better. Now what I mean... Oh yeah, and there's also clothing in the toilet, you know. Let's pick up the clothing. Now what I mean with the fashion guy is, if I hit the vision... You know, I say if I hit the vision. And there we go. We can see all the red powder just everywhere.
This bottle, it has some faint traces of the red powder. This is the evidence I need. This fragrance. I see. This is the new age he was talking about. Let's get it back to its owner. This should get another one in the clear.
So yeah, let's quickly run back and talk to him. Oh, wrong way. Okay.
You're like a rash that just won't go away, aren't you? Can't we handle this in one sitting?
I've found your new age.
That's...
a pretty fancy container. And such a unique aroma. The same as the faint scent I detected coming from you.
Very well. Yes, it is all as you say. That's my latest cosmetic product.
A cosmetic? I thought as much.
You apply the bright red powder here, on this part below your nose. Vertically, along here, like this.
Below your nose?
Yes. People's attention is focused on the center of your face. So, that's where I also focused my attention. On this bit below the nose that I don't even know the name of. Bright red lipstick is outdated now. The new age will be making this part below the nose bright red. Yes, it is truly avant-garde! By sheer coincidence, it matches perfectly with my next theme. One last thing. I need you to keep mum about D with the mass media. I want to make the announcement myself, when the right time comes.
We'll just go fine. It kind of sounds like a dumb idea. But you were just not in agree.
Sure, no problem. It makes no difference to me.
You're smarter than I thought. Suki has changed her opinion of you too.
Alright. And one last thing.
There's something I'd like to ask you though. For my silence. Where were you on January 26, 2011? The day I lost everything.
January 2011? I would have been in Paris from New Year onward.
You can prove it?
Easily. Just check the back issues of any fashion magazine. Suki and I are regulars at the Semaine de la Mode à Paris.
The La Mode what?
Heathen. The premier haute couture show. You've never heard of Paris Fashion Week? What century are you living in?
Sorry. My bad. Sounds like the perfect alibi. It looks like Duncan is in the clear.
That is a thank you. Nothing more. Certainly not to buy your silence. Don't take it the wrong way now.
So the name of the new age is taken from the D of Duncan?
No, not at all. This new cosmetic for application just below the nose has a special fragrance. I'll tell you, but please, discretion. It's a powerful pheromone used by a certain female insect. Such a powerful pheromone. The insect was worshipped in ancient Egypt at...
Don't tell me. D is for dung beetle.
The whole world will fall under the spell of the fragrance of D.
Yes, people. The new fashion trend will be putting fragrance up a dung beetle on your thingy underneath your nose. Yay, poop bug. Which, yeah, they're pretty... Well, I would say they're neat, but they're gross at the same time. But I could ramble about the whole animal and why it rolls up the poop and everything. But that's not really something that's important at the moment. Just know that it does it for a reason. Yeah, I'm content with that. And plus, thinking about it is pretty gross. So, I'm not gonna talk about it. Alright. So yes, we got him out of the clear. Let's talk to our lovely panicked woman who has changed her clothes as well. So, let's push her. And talk to her.
What are you doing that for?
You there. Perfect timing. I can't take it anymore.
Take what?
What is Deborah talking about?
That lightning strike electrified the floor and handrails. So I'm doing my best not to touch them. But I can't take it anymore. My arms, legs, neck, back, everything is screaming in pain.
I need to try and calm it down.
Lightning striking an airplane. Crazy, huh? Do you think this plane is okay?
Oh, I get this feeling we're gonna have to run around the airplane. Let's find out. I know we have to, because I already played this, but I'm curious if I have to again.
First, squeaking windows, and now seats and floors are electrified? I'm almost impressed by your capacity to worry about the mundane.
Hold it! What was that about the windows?
They were squeaking, right?
Squeaking! The windows! You're saying the windows on this bucket squeak? What?
I got to try to take a look at her book. There we go.
You're pulling my leg. If the windows were really squeaking, why, we'd all be dead by now. That lightning strike would have come in through the cracked window. We'd have smashed into the sea, its surface harder than concrete. It's like Dr. Johnson always says, fall from an airplane and you'll die. So just keep your fear-mongering to yourself.
There certainly doesn't seem to be any counting in her notes. What's going on here, then?
So yes, things have changed. For sure.
You also take notes on suspicious people, right?
That's right. There's you, of course, and I've got notes on that guy with the mannequin. Oh, I've got his number. He's one of them object sexuals.
I'll have to take your word for that.
It's a term applied to individuals who fall in love with inanimate objects. Come on, you've heard of it. A type of paraphilia. It's like Dr. Johnson always says, love has no boundaries.
What about the guy with the scar on his forehead? Stony face, in business class?
Oh yes, workaholic, textbook. He's got it bad too. He's either using his work to run away from something, or work itself is his reason for living.
Reason for living.
It's like Dr. Johnson always says, it doesn't matter what it is, just find a reason to live.
Okay. So let's ask about the notebook.
What are you doing now?
I'm rereading my old notes.
Your old ones?
It's your fault. You've got me all riled up. If the window really is squeaking, I need to check if I've got any notes on what to do about it. I'm sure I had something on it. Hey, you, make yourself useful. While I'm reading, you go around and check the windows for me.
Okay, so we still have to do this again.
Didn't I already check the windows?
No complaining, no talking back. Get to work.
Hey, hold on.
Ready? Set? Hurry, hurry, hurry!
So yes, we gotta do another window inspection. But on pause note, I believe it's the last one, unless there's more in like the second episode. But I guess we'll find out when I get there. Oh, there's one. Okay. Jump to this one. And there's that one and that one. And you think with how the airplanes in kind of a dismay, they would honestly start cleaning up the mess. Or seeing those medics on board. I'm just saying, it's kind of weird that it's in such a dismay already. And no one's helping the passengers at all. Okay. Also, I do enjoy the fact our lovely tall doctor is being snoopy in certain scenes. I do find that pretty enjoyable. But we got two more windows, which I believe are this one and that one. And there we go.
The windows aren't squeaking, are they?
Yeah, actually, they aren't.
I can make use of you.
Oh. There's more?
Checking my notes, there's still some stuff I want looked at. Are you with me?
And yes, the show must go on, but I think I'm gonna end the episode here, guys. And the next one we'll pick it up from here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you're enjoying the series so far. Apologies about the delays as well. As usual, like, comment, also subscribe if you haven't, and also check out my other videos as well. And with that, you guys have a good day, and I'll see you in the next ones. Bye!